Maybe there is a lot of feedback on your end. Okay, Mwiri, please continue. Can we, do we make sure Mwiri is spotlighted, please? Can we make sure?
So I bring in the first question part here that says express in terms of B and B, SC, and what we have SC, and the way SC is there on the one. So I will go, so then we make AB plus BC. Bring that SC to B plus AB plus BC. We have data A, B, and data B. And then we're going to take our B, C. Since this is a parallel graph, we took a person side equal. So we have the same breaker. So B, C, 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 we are going to have a lot of so, where is SC? Where is SC? Plus, this is the
good. Mwiri, is there anything we can do with the audio? Mwiri, is there anything we can do with the audio? It's very poor.
Shall we do it now? How do you do it? Then we do it. Then we do it. We do it. We do it. We do it. We do it.
We shall have BA, which is negative B, plus AB, which is vector B. And we shall have vector B, vector D, minus vector B. And this should be vector B.
I'm Tamzade James from Busoga College, Mwiri, and I'll be submitting the next two parts. They told us to find vector VP, which is this vector VP. Vector VP. But vector VP, vector VP, to find vector VP, we've been given this statement here that 2BC, the vector 2BC is equal to 3PC. What to get the ratio?
We want to get the ratio that P seated. We are going to divide by 3. Divide by 3. So here, PC, vector PC, is equal to 2 over 3 BC, which BC is this. So that means BC is taking up 3. So that means PC will have just 2, and then BP will have its proportion as 1. So to find BP, shall say, therefore, BP, vector BP, will be found by getting 1 out of 3 of BC. Of BC. 1 out of 3 of BC. Remember, this is a parallelogram. These two opposite sides are equal. That means if AE is vector D, if AE is vector D, that means BC is also vector D. Therefore, we shall have
Mwiri sound. Mwiri, we have lost your sound. I hope we shall reconnect to me later in the presentation.
But that needs to be.
The sound for me is.
No, they corrected it. They
but it is now off, or it's me who is not here. But if...
the problem you have made it somewhere. You take that thing. The volume is easier, but there is some this thing you're saying.
Tumuine.
I don't know if the problem is. Let me find.
3B plus, I mean, sorry, minus vector D. So this is our PQ.
Now we are going to part B that says if M is the intersection of AC and DB, show that three points M, P, Q are collinear. Now we shall put them in a ratio format. So it's going to be MP to PQ. Then we shall get MP, and getting MP, getting MP, we are going to getting MP, we are going to move MB plus BP. MB plus BP. These are vectors of which our MB is going to be a half of this line, because these are diagonals and they meet at 90, and if they meet at 90, it means that this side is going to be equal to this side. So this will be 1 and this will be 1. That is to mean that MB is going to be a half of DB. Vector D, vector DB. This is going to be a half. And what is vector D? What is DB? We are moving DB, so we are going to use this direction, which is a negative of DA. That is going to be negative DA. I mean negative D, because we are moving the opposite direction of D, plus AB, which is B. So when you get this, they always say it is better to start with the positives, then you end with the negative. So this is MB. Now from MB, we are going to fill in this to get MB, which is going to be a half into brackets B minus B plus our BP. Remember, BP we got a third over vector B. Now from there we are going to, now we are going to equate this to this. Now, let's say we shall first get PQ. PQ. Our vector PQ, we got as 1 over 3. 1 over 3. 3 vector B minus D. So now we shall equate this. This is going to be vector MP to the ratio of PQ. Now we shall say, let me wrap it. We shall say vector MP to PQ. So we shall say is equals to, because we have MP and PQ, so we shall say is equals to the vector of MP. We're still working out this one. So here we shall get over 6, because we shall get the LCM of these two numbers, and this is 6. So 6 divided by 2, you get 3, and then 3 times this, because this is 1, so 3 times 1 will be 3, then you multiply by everything in the brackets, which is going to be 3 vector B minus 3 vector D plus 6 divided by 3, you get 2, and 2 times vector D, that's going to be 2 vector D. Then now we shall come here. That is going to be the same as 3 vector B, because when you add this to negative 3D plus 2D, that's going to be minus vector D over 6, which is going to be the same as 6 vector 3 vector B minus vector
the, now we got our PQ as, because we come here, we got our PQ as a third, into bracket three vector B minus vector B. Now shall I say vector AB to vector PQ is going to be equal to, we shall equate to the ratio that we got, on which this is MP, we got our MP here as a 6, 3 vector B minus, 3 vector B minus vector P, to the ratio of our PQ, we are, because we are equating this, we are just replacing on the opposite side of the equal signs, MP, we got as this, PQ, we got as a third, 3 vector B minus B. And when you look at this, the ones in brackets are common, so they will divide. So here we shall be with MP, will be equals to a 6 to 1 over 3. Because these have divided because they have, they are common. Now we shall come here and say vector MP to vector PQ is going to be equal to. Now here we shall eliminate this. We shall eliminate the fractions by multiplying both sides with the LCM. And if you look at these two numbers, this is 6. The LCM of these two numbers is 6. So we shall multiply both sides by 6. It's going to be 1 over 6 times 6. The ratio of 1 over 3 times 6. So this is going to be vector MP to PQ is going to be equal to 1 ratio of 2. From there, since we have got vector MP to vector PQ as 1 to 2, we shall come here and say M, this is our first vector, and this is the second. When you come this side, this is the first vector to the ratio of the second vector. So we shall come and say the first vector, which is MP over the second ratio vector, which is PQ, is going to be equal to the first ratio here, which is 1, over the second ratio, which is 2. And when you look at this, that means that AB is 1 and PQ is 2. Then, as you see here, the ratio is that. Now, from there, since we are going to have, we shall multiply both sides with PQ. So this is going to be vector MP. It's going to be the same as a half vector. A half vector PQ. This is a half. A half vector PQ. Now, when you reach this step, now here we are going to conclude by saying, since vector MP is equal to the constant PQ, vector MP is parallel to vector PQ. Having a common factor, which is P, it shows that M, P, and Q are collinear. So this will be our answer of part B. Thank you.